control your fortune and copy box and this and do the other thing. You want to go, you wish to go on, you wish to go on, you wish to go on, you wish to go on.
Something has my.
More and more education foundations,
More and more education for the staff and the confidentiality and safety to both patients and staff. Manual fuel, regarding manual fuel dialysis, I cannot imagine that you have renal dialysis unit without manual. And the manual that enables everybody working in the dialysis unit to speak the same language. When you ask any, or ask about any procedure in the unit, and we ask the nurse, or ask a resident, or ask a specialist, or ask a chief person of the unit, all of them must speak the same language. If you will buy a new mobile or a new TV without action, without manual, you will lose a lot of vital functions. So manual hemodialysis is very important for all of you. And it must comprise a lot of policies and procedures. Policies and procedures, in every policy you must write what you are doing, or you must do what you are writing. This is not a copy and paste. Not copy from Harvard Medical School or John Hopkins, no. You must write what you are doing and you must do what you are writing. You must put in these policies. And the policy contain about nine points which must be fulfilled. And there was a policy, if you take speaking about policy of machine disinfection. If a purpose of this policy is for machine disinfection, and the policy statement because disinfection is very important for safety of patient and the staff, and the definition, if there are some medical terms which you need to be defined there, procedure indicates how can you do disinfection of the machine? Can do disinfection or between patients, heat disinfection, you are using chemical disinfection. At the end of the day, at the end of the week, what you are using, Dialox, Clorox. If you are using Clorox, you can assay a Clorox after rinsing of the machine or not. What about external cleaning of the machine? This is very important to be put in details in the procedure. Form and attachment is very important. If you have any form of renal dialysis, you must have points for this form. If you have dialysis fellowship, and then you must have the points and procedure for dialysis fellowship. Who will fill this one? What will be written? Type of the way, and then increase in weight, after titration, type of dialyzer, machine number, and anticoagulants, how can you give anticoagulants? A vital sign, they can give you 15 minutes or 30 minutes or 1 hour. And then the shots in notes. This must be filled by nurse and signed by the resident and signed by the specialist in the unit. So for every form you have, you must have push and procedure. Who will deal with this for? Also, this is material equipment, this is equipment in the policy. Review history, this is done for the first time, or this is the second or third revision, elephants and then approval. And in the policy, you must have all these points. Most of the procedures regarding patient related, cardiac request and patient specifically assessment of medical status of the patient. When you will see patient for the first time, you must have policy. How can you deal with patient for the first time? Patient coming to you to the unit for the first time. What is the assessment of this patient? Patient diabetic or not, diabetic, what medication, hypertension or not, ischemic or not, dyslipidemic or not, collagen disease, what medication he received, what is the investigation, hypocalcemic, hyperkalemic, acidotic, and then is there vascular access or not, what is the virus screening, hepatitis B, C, HIV, You must ask for all this. Also, you must ask for the medical insurance. Who will cover this patient during dialysis? And then, how can I put him? I put him for 2 hours, and then 2.5 hours, 3 hours, and then 4 hours. This is very important to have initial assessment for your patient and the assessment between dialysis sessions. Also, here, nursing care during dialysis is very important. Fluid management of dialysis, intravenous drug administration. Especially very important drugs like vancomycin. If you will give vancomycin, you give vancomycin over 1 hour at the end of dialysis or at the start of dialysis. If you will give albumin, give albumin over 1 hour or 1.5 hours, or you give albumin in 5 minutes. It is very important. If you have some medication to be taken IV, you have policy how to take these medications. And also anticoagulant regimen. It is very important to have an unfractionated heparin or low nuclear heparin. If no molecular weight heparin, what is the dose of unfractionated heparin? You get what is the dose of heparin? You give heparin both at the start and then every hour you give heparin or continuous heparin infusion. If the patient has a bleeding tendency, you will shift it to heparin free. How can you do heparin free dialysis? Heparin free dialysis you can do, you can flush the lines every 15 minutes or every 30 minutes. And you can add this positive volume to the net after filtration or not. It is very important to be in details in anticoagulation of your patient. Also, diagnostic test, I will speak about this one later on. Managing vascular access. How can you connect your patient if the patient has temporal catheter or belvicat or any graft or any fistula? How can you connect? And how can you disconnect? It is very important. It is very important to be written in details. Also, good blue arrest protocol. If you have good blue arrest protocol, so not if your patient arrested in the unit, how can you deal with him? And you have already have certificate in basic life support, have certificate in advanced cardiac life support, have crash cart in your unit, crash cart containing endotracheal tube, ammo bag containing a lot of medication like catecholamines, dopamine, dopamine, and so on. When you don't have anything, if you don't have things, this is unsafe totally for your patient. You must have all of this. If this patient is arrested and you have in private unit, to what place you will refer this patient, you must put in your policy. If there is cardiac arrest and I can resuscitate this patient, and you refer him to a specific hospital. What is this hospital? It is very important to be clear in your policy. Management of complications, this must be written CVG, and this is, I think, this is the role of the Egyptian Society of Nephrology to have a written CVG for dealing with some complications during the dialysis, like hypertension, nausea, vomiting, chest pain, and so on. The laser selection and the grinding is very important. Water treatment, I will speak later on, and the type of dialysis. Infection control, what immunization guidelines? You have protocol for immunization for your patient. This patient received the hepatitis B vaccine, received the pneumococcal vaccine, received the influenza vaccine, or you didn't give vaccine for the patient at all. It is very important. What about your staff? You give vaccination to your staff or not? It is very important, immunization guidelines, infection prevention. Infection, it is important, cleaning the procedures, hand washing. Hand washing is very important to know the number one in prevention of transmission of infection. And don't smile, this is the rule, hand washing is very mandatory. A handling of infectious waste is very important, but also the handling of infected or contiguous patient. If you have open TB in the unit, you have negative machine or not negative suction machine. If you don't have negative suction machine, please, an open TB, don't dialyze in the unit. You must have to dialyze open TB. Or active infection, you must have negative air condition room. It's very important. You don't have, don't dialyze an open TB, don't dialyze infectious pneumonia. It's very important. Also, recommend the operating and service manual is very important. You must record the bill for every machine, dress code in the treatment area, safety, general safety, infection control, thorough handling of hazardous waste, electrical safety, fire safety, needle engine, and the staff immunization. Needle engine, if the patient is having a stick needle engine for hepatitis B or C, what you are doing? One of your staff and stick to buy needle with hepatitis B, what you are doing? You must have protocol. If you don't have protocol, you can't take work. Suppose your staff to hazards. It is very important if you must say this patient has stick engine for hepatitis B. You must wash this one thoroughly by soap and water, must give hepatitis B immunoglobulin, you must start hepatitis B vaccination. If the patient HIV, you must give three medication for at least 1 month. If the patient hepatitis C, you must follow your patient and to give the treatment early. So you must put your plan. If there is a stick injury for your patient, for your staff, what you are doing? Don't put your staff at risk to catch infection and you will not do anything. It is very important. This is one of the recommendations of the quality. Housekeeping is very important. And then regular investigation and action plan. This is the monthly investigation month for the unit. This is every 3 months, and this is every 6 months. You must put in your mind what's the action plan. This is suppose an nurse said to you, this paper, believe doctor, this patient has serum potassium 6.5. Okay, ask your patient to reduce the juice and the fruits. No, this is not an action plan. Action means they have a very potential serious problem. Patient has hyperkalemia. Patient can be dying at any time at home from cardiac arrest. You must put action, because how can I do for this patient? I must educate him. I must revise his medication. I've taken medication causing hyperkalemia, not like this inhibitor or ARBs. I can reduce this patient. The patient is on twice the dialysis weekly. I can increase it 3 times. I can increase surface area. I can correct acidosis by sodium bicarbonate. I can, this patient also can, I can use potassium, low potassium or potassium pre-dialysate. This patient also, I can give him medication, like calcium zirconium or ventolin if the patient is not cardiac. So there is very important to put action plan for every investigation. Not the patient, don't say to your nurse, please you can inform the patient to reduce the juice and reduce the protein. No, this is not your job. Your job to put action plan, and you must register this action plan. You must document this action plan. Regarding clinical indicators, all of us must ask themselves where we are in the unit and what can we do for this to improve this figure. As Dr. Hassan said in the first session, and at access use in first steps, access use in first steps must be through any fistula by 60 or 65% of patients. If less than 60% of patients coming into your unit without any fistula, there is a problem in the referring and nephrology consultant. Because he must refer this patient too early to do AV fistula, to come to you with vascular access. But it is very important how many patients, what is the percentage of patients coming to you with AV fistula? Or at any time prevalence in your unit, how many, what is the percentage of patients AV fistula? Must be benchmark figures, it is 85% of your patients must have AV fistula. These are benchmark figures. If less than it, if the number of patients with AV fistula is less than this figure, there is a problem. There is a problem regarding referring your patient to the vascular surgeon. It is very important. And also, if you make any investigation here, like serum albumin, how many patients with serum albumin more than 3.5? And how many patients with serum albumin less than 3.5? Why is this patient has hyperalbuminemia? Patient with poor dialysis? A patient is nutritionally poor. A patient has other causes for hypoalbuminemia like liver cirrhosis. What are the causes? Because hypoalbuminemia is a risk factor for infection. So you must categorize your patient according to the benchmark figures of investigation. Also infection rate. How many patients seem prevented? Patient can hepatitis B negative or hepatitis C negative, and the patient can become hepatitis C positive. You must every year, you must put in your mind how many patients seroconverted. If there is a lot of patients seroconverted, there is a problem. Actually, there is a problem in your unit. If there is a lot of infection in the catheter, there is a problem in your unit. You must advise your nurse. You must educate them. You must educate the patients more and more. But it is very important. Also, to have adequacy. How many patients reaching the target of TPO4D? And how many patients want to ice treatment, because this is decreased all over the world now, most of the patients now 3 times a week. You must inform your patients about any technology in the hemodialysis. High calcium in brain is very important for any patient on dialysis more than 3 or 5 years. Why? Because the beta 2 microglobulin, and the removal of beta 2 microglobulin with high calcium in brain is 60% versus 20%. Lufthansa membrane. So a beta 2 microglobulin accumulated can lead to dialysis related malignancies and cause disfigure for the patient. Patient won't prepare this disability. But it is very important if you have a new technology in the machine in the dialysis procedure, you must inform your patient and your high flux membrane, because you are taking a patient now, you are more than 3.5 years, and you will be exposed. 2 beta 2 microglobulin accumulation, that's late amyloidosis. So high flux membrane is very important for you. So it is very important to inform your patients about any advance. Also, the reservation of residual kidney function. You can become with your patient that's early with residual kidney function, say 20 ml per minute. But it is very important, because if the residual kidney function can decrease the beta 2 microglobulin, will decrease the need for ultrafiltration. So you must have policy and procedure for patients with residual kidney function. Any patient with residual renal function must force and procedure to avoid intradialytic hypertension, because intradialytic hypertension can lead to more and more deterioration of kidney function, And also, a use of nephrine, we must avoid nephrotoxic drugs. Don't say that this patient not on dialysis, I can use nephrotoxic medication. No, this patient still have residual kidney function. So you must, you must preserve this kidney, residual kidney function, because it is vital for the patient. Your machine must be working for 7 to 10 years or 25,000 to 40,000 hours. Multidisciplinary team. It is very important to have patient and family educator for every 100 patients. Social worker for every 100 patients. One doctor for every 50 patients. One nurse for every 3 patients. This is international figures. If you have a patient family educator, it's very important. Because he will educate the patient about it. A lot of things like about kidney failure, modality of the dialysis, renal replacement therapy, compliance with diet, compliance with medication, cleaning the vascular access, good hygiene, awareness of prevention, about psychological effects of renal failure. It's very important that you have patient educator. And also, it's very important to have social worker. Social worker can evaluate the home situation. They must know what is the social background of your patient. It will help you. That is very important to have social welfare also. And the renal dietitian for all aspects of diet. And the biomed, this is for the machine and water treatment unit. And the pharmacist for medication. Vascular access, as I said before, is 65% of all patients commencing dialysis should commence with the fistula. 85% of all pregnant patients in dialysis should receive dialysis by a functioning AV fistula, while vascular access planning should commence in chronic kidney stage 4. When this patient will expect that this patient will be put on dialysis within 3 months, you must ask him for AV fistula. But if more than 1 year, don't ask him for AV fistula currently. But if you may ask the patient for graft, as Dr. Atsa has said in the first day, and yes, graft can be used on the second or third day. So I can postpone this patient for 2 or 3 or 4 days before that. But patient for any fistula must commence within 3 months from the start of dialysis. Tunneling catheter is very important. If you have temporary catheter and will be in use for more than 3 weeks, you must transfer your patient to tunneling catheter. To minimize the infection, please, if you have temporary catheter, and then you will expect that the patient will use this temporary catheter more than 3 weeks, you must transfer this patient to do bending cath. This is the vascular access. About water treatment unit, it is very important. The worst way to help the patients in dialysis unit is through water system. It's very important. So it is expected that you know what is going on in the water system. It is very important. Don't say that a water treatment unit, this is the responsibility of biomed, and you are the doctor staying in the unit, you don't know anything about water treatment unit. No. This is number one, hurting your patient. This is number one causing harmful effects for your patient. This is the cause of mortality for your patient. You must know everything about water treatment unit. There is what is known as any standard, which is international standard for water treatment. And the rationale for this, and the patient is exposed to about 300 liters of water every week. And in the Boston, there is a patient consumption in one session, 120 liters, including the dialysate. In a week, in 3 sessions, about 300 liters passing through non-selective membrane. The حين ان الشخص العادي can consume 12 liters per week and highly selective membrane اللي هو جي اي تي. Completely different. That 12 liters وفي highly selective membrane, انما ده 300 liters with non-selective membrane. So this patient will be exposed to actually a lot of hazards through water treatment. So for water treatment unit, TDS or total dissolved solutes and conductivity must be done daily. TDS and conductivity, microbiology and the endotoxin assay monthly, and the chemical assay annually. If you will hear, this is the chemical. This is the chemical figures. And then this is the culture. This is the allowed microbiology contaminants of the dialysis fluid. not more than 100 polymorphic units per ml for bacteria and 0.25 for endotoxin. If it is reached 50% of these figures, and 50 here, or 0.125 here, you must take an action. Take an action and you must revise disinfection of your water treatment unit, you must revise the bacteria filter, you must revise the ultraviolet, you must revise the RO membrane. It is very important, you must do it. You must do this culture. And this is the... Here also, this one is the alarming one. There must be alarm sound. Yeah, you must have alarm in the unit for the water treatment unit. If the water treatment in the storage tank is decreasing significantly, you must have alarm. If there is a problem in the conductivity, you must have alarm. If there is a problem in total dissolved solutes, you must have alarm in the unit to know what is the type of water. But it is very important, and also the culture must be collected from the main water treatment unit and from every two machines or three machines per month to cover all the units through the machines in one year. يعني كل شهر بتعمل مكانتين أو ثلاثة تعرف الكالشر بتاعهم وتشوف لو الكالشر بتاعهم زاد عن الليمت أنت you must do this machine and the door out of order. You must disinfect this machine once, twice, three times لغاية ما تعيد الكالشر والكالشر تبقى نيجاتيف. That is very important. Infection control. What is your staff is doing regarding hand hygiene? You must ask these questions for yourself. What is your staff? How to prevent hepatitis spread? All our patients are changing gloves between patients or not? Be hand washing things distant from dirty things or not? What about clamps? What about the next excess water? Hands free or not? And regarding the disinfection done by the original way or not? Also, anything cannot be cleaned like a TV or controls or clamps or Cisco or remote camera, that must be also cleaned and disinfected. It is very important. Regarding hepatitis B, it is very important to isolate your patient with hepatitis B in a separate room. Don't put the patient on the other room, don't put the hepatitis B machine on your patient, must be isolated. Regarding hepatitis C, in high prevalent area like Egypt, you must also isolate the hepatitis C. Yeah, you must have two rooms for isolation. One isolated room for hepatitis B and one isolated room for hepatitis C. Because the prevalence of hepatitis C in Egypt is very high. And you must protect your negative patient. And what about hepatitis B screening and patient serology and vaccination? You must vaccinate your patient, must have policy about vaccination. You get double dose, 0, 1, and 6 months, and then you will do hepatitis B cells antibody after 1 or 2 months. If it's still negative, you will give booster dose. If you repeat again and it's still negative, you will give booster dose. If it repeat again and it's still negative, you give 4 booster successive dose. If at the end it's still negative, okay, this is a non-responder patient. You consider this as a non-responder patient. Like you must give the hepatitis B vaccine, how you will follow a hepatitis B vaccine. And also you must give to your staff. You must screen your staff for hepatitis B, CHIV, at least every 6 months or at least every 1 year. And you must give vaccination for your staff. It is very important. We want to know that hepatitis B can survive on inanimate surface for several days. Hence the precaution in dialysis units are much more stringent than universal precaution. يعني ممكن الهباتيتس بي يبقى موجود من 7 ايام ل 10 ايام 15 على المشين على البيت. علشان كده لو بصينا لده ان اكوردنج تو سي دي سي غير مسموح ان يكون عندك عيان واحد الهباتيتس بي وتقول والله ان انا ده عندي بس مرتين او ثلاثه في الاسبوع اغيره ده في اليوم اللي ما بيسيبش فيه وعقم الغرفه والكلام ده كانوت بي غير مسموح. مش مسموح لو حاله واحده لو ما عندكش عيان الهباتيتس بي. لكن if you have only one patient hepatitis B, don't share hepatitis B positive with hepatitis B negative. لأن hepatitis B virus هتلاقيه على كل حتة في الغرفة بتاعت الايزوليشن. فإت إز فيري امبورتنت هاف only one patient hepatitis B must occupy a room. هنا الهاند سانيتايزر إز فيري امبورتنت. في نوع سانيتايزر بتتحط هاند سانيتايزر كده instead of hand wash can be put beside every machine. between patients who must use this hand sanitizer is very important and very cheap. Also, regarding the refrigerator, if you have a refrigerator and you put some medications in the refrigerator, you must check the temperature of the refrigerator every day. Every day. يعني ممكن يكون التمبريتشر بتاع الفريجريتور نازل، ممكن يكون في مشكله في الثلاجه دي، تبص تلاقي كل الميديكيشن اللي انت حاططها باظت. فيو ماست تشيك التمبريتشر اوف الفريجريتور افري داي. Regarding morbidities and mortalities, you must concentrate in category 4 and 5 اللي هو البريفنتبل اللي هو الانتيسيبيتد بس وبيشن تيرمينال ايلنس ولا تكون بيزهم نو بروبلم. لكن يكون البيشن في بريفنتبل بس وانت يو نوت دو your rule, this is very important that you need to legally enter the hassle on it. If I for category 4 and 5, and I come to serve medication or serve an interview, you didn't give your patient the optimum care and deliver him to die, although the cause of the mortality is preventable. Documentation is very important, and I think that all my colleagues working outside Egypt, it knows nowhere that documentation is very important. This is a habit. This is a habit. And you must inform your residents. And you do write every day in progress notes. It is very important. It is a habit. And you must, patient consent, supply, pre-procedure care, intra-procedure care, post-procedure care, management of communication. You must write for this one. You must have log book for vaccination. And you must inform your patient. The patient received vaccines today and after 1 month. And the patient, and you must know that the patient will receive another vaccine, say in May 2014. It's very important. You have blood book for vaccination, you have blood book for water quality. Regarding culture control machine, or culture kettle, TDS, daily TDS, you must have documentation for all these things. This is the last point in our corporate social responsibility. Any organization must have social responsibility, then masculinity, and muftamai. It's very important that you can employ some of patients or their relatives, charity projects to help them financially, patient education through lectures or TV or brochures or leaflets, energy and water save, which is very important. This is the last slide. Lower to 1 degree in dialysis. Now we started to use this one in a few hospitals since about 1.5 years, but now this one is published internationally, 2013 International Society for Hemodialysis, about rejected water. Any water coming to the RO, there is some rejected water to be bathed outside, and then the remaining water passed to the machine. Rejected water that day, حوالي 30 إلى 40% من المية اللي داخلة على الRO. يعني 30 إلى 40% من المية اللي داخلة على الRO بتبقى rejected to outside. You must reuse this one. Can be used in sanitation problem, say, مثلا, flushing toilets, في laundry, في washing cars, في irrigation plants, anything. لكن this rejected water will pass to the drain directly. واحنا داخلين على أزمة مية، أزمة مية حقيقية. فيبقى دلوقتي كمية المية اللي هي rejected من الـ RO must be reused again, not for dialysis. Because this is a very hard water. Not reused again for dialysis, but reused for other girls, which is very important here, and they can save in France about 1,200 square meter, cubic meter per year. It's a very big figure. There are only one dialysis unit, only. And in America, there are only dialysis units in Mosul. It is very important for them to have a marshalic shortage of water. Finally, my conclusion. And it is a time to take a step forward. I think it is a time to take a step forward. I think it is a time for the Ministry of Health to link between the price of the dialysis session and the minimum requirements of quality. There must be minimum requirements of quality, must be fulfilled in all dialysis units, and the unit fulfilling all these criteria must increase the cost, which is the price of dialysis session. Can now 120 or 130 pounds, can increase to 200 pounds to the unit fulfilling the criteria of quality. Thank you.
Samir, I'm not sure how to say الحركه الفتانيه في المركز كانت السن الصغير. وكانت على الكونتيتا بتروس الكروم بعد حطيت السي بعد كده. ترس المير اتحرك. ترس المير بيتميز اكتمالك الخاصه بوصول المعلومه. واعتقد اللي ما يعرفش هذا الكلام المحاضره دي بتساوي ملخص للهيمو دايلس سكول مع بعض. انا هعلق اصلا من طين واسيبه الصبح بعد كده يسال سؤال. هو حضرتك قلت البيشن دي البيشن كام؟ البيشن دي البيشن نقطه من النقاط اللي احنا بندخلها. ولو هو لقى المكيت بشكل كويس بيفيد نفسه وبيفيد السيرفس وساعات بيحمي من حدوث مشاكل بتحصل نتيجه لبعض الغفله اللي بتحصل. فالاديوكيشن وان احنا كومبات الليترسي ده شيء مهم جدا في الهيمو دايلس. النقطة اللي كنت عايز اسألك فيها السؤال اللي سألته الدكتور هاني عبد الخالق الهوكر هيباتيتس بي بتعمل في ايه؟ يعني واحد كان هيباتيتس بي اتسأل بوستر وبقى نيجاتيف والانتي كور بوستر هل بتزيله بالهوكر بي ولا بتعمل ايه بالظبط؟
والله يا البرومت دي بتتعلم بسرعة لأحد المشاكل اللي بتقابلنا بيشنت وده الحقيقة فتحت المشكلة دي مع أروح هيباتولوجيست قبل كده البيشنت لأن أنت لما بيجيلك البيشنت بيزيل هيباتيتس بي سيلز أنتي بودي الرجل دي سيلز انتي بودي بوزيتيف ده بيبقى بيشنت حاجه من اثنين يا اما فاكسينيتد يا اما بوست انفكشن. تعرف هو بقى الفرق بين فاكسينيتد وبوست انفكشن ازاي هتعمل هيباتيتس بي 4 انتي بودي. لو هيباتيتس بي 4 انتي بودي بوزيتيف يبقى البيشنت ده بوست انفكشن. لو هيباتيتس بي 4 انتي بودي نيجاتيف يبقى البيشنت ده فاكسينيتد.
بس انا ما بخافش من الاثنين اه الاثنين دول سولونج از الانتي اس انتي بودي فوق الليفل اللي احنا عاوزينه
تمام
لكن انا بتكلم ما عندوش الليفل بتاع انتي بودي الانتي اس وعنده انت كور وكان قبل كده هيباتيتس بي هتديله من غسيل من وحده البي من الاوضه بتاع البي ولا غسيل ولا
بتاع الاوضه اتفتح القصه دي السؤال كذا مره لانه سؤال بيرد في
ولا في روم للكومبتيتيف بي سي ار؟
هو كومبتيتيف بي سي ار طبعا بدون شك كومبتيتيف بي سي ار بس انت في الاخر بتتكلم على سيلو كونفرجن
يعني لو لقيت كومبتيتيف بي سي ار معمول من طمالك مفيش رقم
نيجاتيف نيجاتيف هو كان السؤال اللي كان بيوجهه الباثولوجيست يقول لك هل البيشنت ده ينفع ينقل بلط؟ يعني انت لو تاخد مثلا منه بلط ترانسفيوجن ينفع البيشنت ده تاخد منه بلط ترانسفيوجن اور نوت؟ فكان السؤال لا طب اذا كان مش هقدر اخد منه بلط يبقى مش هتنقل انت خد بالك؟ يعني هو قلت لك هو ده ديفيكال بس عشان البيشنت اللي كفايه نيجاتيف
ديفيكال بس عشان واضح النقطه ديفيكال انت لو سبته وبقى بعد كده بص فقالك انت اللي السبب ان ده كده بص ولو نقلت عيان في الصاله اللي بقى بوستر يبقى انت عملت هزيمه.
اقول لك بقى بنشوف كتير دلوقتي هيباتيتس سي يقلب نيجاتيف مش بس بي. الحل اللي انا شايفه انا عندي برضه في دكاتره عاملين كتير في الحكومه بقول له لو سمحت انقل واحده ثانيه. مش عامل. في وحدات الكلى في مصر اي داوت ان يمكن يكون وحده بتعمل الكلام ده. ماشي؟ يمكن يكون في حد الكلام اللي اتقال ده كله وفي نفس الوقت انا سينيور نيكرولوجيست وزمان سينيور نيكرولوجيست كنا اوير من ان ايه هو دايركت بيشنت اند ماشين كونتاكت احنا بعيد دلوقتي. ف ما اعتقدش طيب والاجيال الصغيره عاشت في هذه الاوساط ان احنا بنكون بعيد عن الايضا يمكن الدكتور اشرف مره راح السويس ونفى انه يروح يعمل تقرير على وحدات كده صناعه في السويس وشاف الوحدات وطلع يعني التقرير ممكن تقول ان احنا عايشين في فضيحه بتاع دايس دكتور اشرف مش كده؟ اهمال فظيع فانا اعتقد الجمعيه المصريه اكيد عندها برامج لتطوير الدارك كارت بتاع الليمفال دايلس ومحتاجه اعتقد مش دكتور سمير في نزله ان الكلام اللي ده هو بيعيشه هو متشرد انه يمارسه من اكثر من كذا 20 سنه مثلا يعني هو كل حرف قاله متشربه تماما وبالتالي انا اعتقد الجماعه المصريه لو هتعمل برنامج ان تطوير الخدمه من هذا الكلام اذا كانت تدور على شخص هو سمير. انا اعتقد سمير في صفه ثانيه. سمير انا اعرفه من وظيفه يعني احب بلده مع انه يعني له مسؤوليات كبيره جدا في الجلده. لو كنت لو الجمعيه كانت كتبته رسميا ان يتبنى ان يبقى كتنفيذ لهذا الشيء هيقدر يقدر. فانا اعتقد الكلام ده مشكله عندنا في مصر، واعتقد محتاجين الجمعيه المصريه يجب يكون لها دور، مش وزاره الصحه اللي تعمل كده، لا جانب علمي لها دور لتنظيف الغسيل الدموي في مصر عشان تكون تيم عاوز ناس ديديكيتد وعاوز واحد تشرب هذا الشيء. فانا بقترح يعني الجماعه تقول هذا الكلام ان انا اعتقد مش هقول لها يعني في وقت ما في جمعيه تقوم بهذه المسؤوليه، ويبقى الدكتور سمير له دور هام ان لم يكن هو رئيس فيها.
شاملة لكل الاسئله وطبعا لو هو رضا انه يجي طبعا لا يعني الدكتور نسير الحقيقه ابتدى السنه دي بالذات فيري اكتف بروجرام في المكان اللي احنا واخدينه كمقر الجمعيه كنوع من التدريب. بس معظم يعني الاسبكت اللي بيغلب عليه حتى الان هو الاسبكت النظري اكتر. ف what we want to add ويمكن هو دي هتبقى الاضافه المهمه جدا اللي الدكتور سمير عملها لنا، اننا نعمل في نفس يا اما نقدر نعمل في نفس المكان يا اما احنا كان في فيجن اننا نشتري مكان اكبر، لان الحمد لله ما زال عندنا فلوس. بس طبعا ما زال عندنا فلوس كويسه، كنا بنفكر ان ناخد ماتش بيجر بليس من مقر الجمعيه ويبقى في اسورت اوف ايديا دياليسيز يونت يعني يتمرنوا فيها ناس براكتيكال كل الستبس وكل الكلام ده على نوع من المانيكانات زي ما بتتعمل مثلا مودلز بالظبط او كده زي مركز تدريب مثلا اللي هو بتاع الاطفال الصحه العباسيه. يبقى في حاجات ايه ممكن يتدرب عليها النفرولوجيست على كل التفاصيل اللي حضرتك قلتها، ويبقى في زي نوع من الكاردز اللي هم بيعدوا ويتحكموا فيها ويفيل اف ذي دونت دو certain steps بعد كل تريننج ستيشن، واللي يعمل الحاجات دي كلها صح يبقى ايه ياخد اسورت اوف سيرتيفيكت ان هو هي باست ذيس كورس. يعني نحاول نحول هذه الجايد لاينز الى something practical to be applied في كورس حضرتك تتبناه. لو قدرنا نعمل كده تبقى البوينت الثاني بقى هو المهمه ان الجمعيه المفروض يبقى لها نوع من الشرط الرقابي.
هو ده
الشرط الرقابي بقى يعني احنا جزء تعليمي طبعا بس براكتيكال سيت اب. بس لا ما هو برضه شباب محتاجين مزيد من التعليم. الجزء الثاني البراكتيكال احنا الحقيقه في الجمعيه كان عندنا سم انيشيشن من حوالي ثلاث اربع سنين اننا عملنا اسورت اوف بوكلت، والبوكلت ده اديناه لوزاره الصحه ويمكن حضراتكم ايه اتعرض على الجمعيه قبل ما ايه قبل ما تشوفوا الفاينل فورم بتاعنا. وفي يعني فيري ستيف عايز اقول ايه جايد لاينز المفروض انها تطبق في الوحدات. يعني بنقول للوحدات لازم تقيسوا كي تي اوفر في، بنقول للوحدات لازم الافرج هيموجلوبين اوف بيشنتس يبقى ايه كذا، الافرج البومين اوف بيشنتس كذا، ولكن تفتقر هذه الحاجات للمتابعه. وما زالت الحتت يعني في الجهات الرقابيه في وزاره الصحه، احنا طبعا كجمعيه ما عندناش سلطه رقابيه، يعني احنا سلطه في النهايه بنقترح جايد لاينز تبقى شكلها ايه، لكن السلطه الرقابيه في وزاره الصحه اللي هي الجهه اللي ممكن تخش مثلا في وحده معينه وتقلقها، تقول لك انه الووتر تريتمنت في هذا المكان غير مطابق او ان الهيباتايتس مش معزول او ان لكن ما بيبصش للحاجات اللي حضرتك قلتها، ما بيبصش مثلا للكواليتي، ما بيبصش للمورتاليتي، ما بيبصش للانفكشن كنترول ميجرز ابلاي ولا مش ابلاي، هو بيبص على حاجات كروت كده شويه حاجات كروت. واحنا في الادمنستريتيف سيستم بتاعنا جمعيتنا الان جي اوز كلها في مصر ليس لها سلطه رقابيه، فالحل هو ان احنا يعني كجمعيه نفوز اور سيلف شويه على الجهات الرقابيه في الصحه، يعني بمعنى اننا ندخل نفسنا شويه معاهم ونقول ان الجمعيه لازم يبقى لها سي انه بعد الكورس ده ما الناس تعدي فيه يبقى كونسلتد جمعيه مع الشخص اللي بيروح يبارك انه ممكن يبقى عنده ضبطيه قضائيه ما يرفع عليه ضبطيه قضائيه ان هو يقول الحته دي زي ما حضرتك قلت ان الحته دي زباله مثلا ما ينفعش خالص في السويس يبقى ايه؟ يبقى الضبطيه القضائيه مش نقول بس بقى يبقى تعني ان الوحده دي بتقفل مثلا بقرار اغلاق لمده ايه؟ ست شهور لغايه ما صلح نفسها. لو وصلنا كده يبقى فيها مشكله.
يعني لو انا قلت الاعضاء الجمعيه هتكون ناس بتمارس الدايلس بتاخد يعني زي شهاده من الجماعه المصريه ان بتاع دايلس وبروح يشتغل بيه يبقى كجزء من الكونتينوس ميديكال اديوكيشن ايه المانع ان يبقى عندك سنترال في القاهره بس تعمل حاجه زي الاوت ريتش بروجرام بتاع الدكتور حسين ده وفي مخ كبير بيدورها ان الناس اللي كانوا ناسين هنا انا اديتك تصريح دايلس بس انا عندي الحق ان انا اسمع لهم تصريح منك انا اعمل لك تريننج دوره تريننج اسبوع في كل المنطقه مثلا الاهليه الشيخ اسوان او ريش بروجرام سمير مسؤول عنه مش مهم بودي موجود هيز بريدي ونقعد الاخر بيتحرك بحيث بيجمع الناس اللي بتعمل درس في حكم الشيخ هيديهم تريننج كورس وممكن يعمل اكزام بسيط ومن حقه يعمل فيزيت يبص على اي واحده في النهايه يكتب تقرير للجمعيه المصريه الجمعيه المصريه ممكن ملهاش ممكن انا افكت على الوزاره دايركت او بالسياسه او بالاعلام
هي بالسياسه
فلازم
يعني لازم احنا ندخل نفسنا مع الوزاره في كجهه ايه؟
ما نتحمسش في السنترال
يعني هم الان هم اللي عندهم الجهه الرقابيه واحنا ما عندناش
ما نتحمسش في القاهره خلاص انا عاوز اوت ريتش صح؟ يعني خلينا
انا بس بضم صوتي على محمد فوق الحماس اللي كان بيتكلم بيه دكتور سمير خلى الكلام بتاعه يدخل جوه الجروب بشكل مباشر وحسست وانا قاعد بسنسيشن اوف جلد لان كل الكلام معلوم الناس بتعرف لكن is not imposed is not practiced فيعني انا بدعو ان نفس الموضوع ده to be repeated more and more بس انا عاوز اقترح اقتراح لان احنا المراكز غسيل الكلى اوفرلود وما تقدرش تقفل مركز لان انت لو قفلت مركز عينه هيموت فانا بقترح نعمل حاجه ثانيه تشجيعيه زي نظام الاجريتيشن اللي حصل في الجامعه ده ان يحصل فيه سنترز اوف اكسلنس السنترز اوف اكسلنس دي تاخد حقوق احسن من السنترز العاديه وبالتالي كلها هيتنافس عليها يكون ثمن الجلسه فيه مرتفع شويه يكون لها تسهيلات التحويلات او كلام زي ده برضه هيعوز العلاقه ما بين الجمعيه والوزاره يتعمل سنترز اوف اكسلنس وتنتشر في كل انحاء الجمهوريه ودي هتبقى الموديل الكلي يعني
شكرا استاذ عشان الوقت هيكون نفس السيشن ده قبل الصوت عشان احنا عشان الوقت برضه هنعمل فيشه في الجلسه اللي جايه الجلسه اللي جايه المفروض كانت فيها نزلنا خمسه نزلنا واحد فاللي هيقول الاول الدكتور مجدي الشرقاوي قايل لي الدكتور محمد عبد الوهاب الدكتور محمد صبح يعني قال ان هو دول بكره بحيث يدي مساحه للناس اللي هي بتكسب بس فانا اتمنى ان هم يموتوا المحاضرتين ما تزيدش عن ساعه واحد ونص ساعه